Outstanding!
Welcome to my expat moving story. I'm Lauren Inglis, and I'm so happy to be bringing you part 4 of our 5-part interview series with South African expat Gail Webster. In part 4, we're going to focus on her experiences with the relocation companies she dealt with, and what she liked and what she didn't like. A lot to learn here, so stay tuned.
Relocating to a new home. New people. New schools. New beginnings and new adventures. Shared with all, right here, on My Expat Moving Story, with our host Lauren Inglis.
So, tell me about what actions or plans for your relocation taken by the relocation company or the moving company made you feel really supported during your moves around the world?
Well, Lauren, we actually didn't have I didn't have any personal contact with a relocation company as such. My husband dealt with the HR. They have got within his company, there are quite a lot of expats, around the world. So they've got quite a standard procedure. It was mainly done by email, maybe one or two telephone calls with my husband, but mainly via email. You know, when we were moving to Europe, we got an email with, it's like a Europe pack, like Belgium, you know, what areas to look at or whatever, but nothing from a personal point of view, I have to say. When we moved, our first move from Cape Town to Belgium, they left it in my hands to get quotes. I think they gave me a list of about 4 companies to use, and I got the quotes myself, sent it back to the my husband to the HR company, and they then chose one, and we went about it that way. The same in Dubai, we got a couple of quotes, and but unfortunately, I didn't have any one-to-one contact, which I think definitely...
That actually sort of leads into my next question. I was going to ask as well. I mean, for us in the moving industry, we are very, more often than not, asked to manage the move with the spouse of the assignee. So I always like to ask the question, as a traveling spouse, do you feel like you were offered sufficient spousal support for your relocations?
Unfortunately not, Lauren. To be honest with you, I think with my husband's company, he dealt with the HR department, and because they have quite a lot of expats around the world, maybe they felt that the way they dealt with it, you know, just via email, sending out email packs of what to expect in each country. It was definitely sufficient, but having one-on-one contact with someone, especially from a spouse point of view, because at the end of the day, we are the ones that happy wife, happy life, you know, you want to find a nice home or a nice apartment. It's got to be near somewhere where the wife is able to access maybe shops or the trains or whatever. So, you know, at the end of the day, I'll never forget with my first expat posting, wherever the hubby, he works for the same company, you know, so his life doesn't change as much because he's doing the same job or within the same company, might be a different job, but within the same company deals with the same people. Whereas for a spouse, it's a traveling spouse, it definitely is a big life change. Yeah. So I think having a personal contact with a relocation consultant or somebody in that position when you get to a new country definitely makes a big difference. It makes you feel a lot more secure in your move.
Okay, that's good to know. And what about in your previous relocations? Have you been asked to complete a quality survey to rate the services of your moving company or your relocation management company? And do you make sure that you do send feedback?
I do, Lauren. I'm very for that. You know, in my previous my career, I was always it was always customer service related. So I know how important it is to send feedback, be it good or bad. And I think honest feedback is really the most important. And every move we've had, I have been asked to fill in a survey And I've been 100% honest with it, be it good or be it bad. I think it's very important because the only way you can improve is by getting honest feedback. So yes, I do fill in the surveys, and I highly recommend every company make sure that the clients fill them out.
And because you're the spouse of the actual assignee, does that survey come to you, or does it generally go to your husband and he just says to you, right, you can get on with it?
Yeah, it does. It goes to hubby and he sends it to me. And he says for me to do it, because at the end of the day, I think the spouse or the one that isn't working is the one that actually does all the behind the scenes work, so to speak. You know, we deal with the crew, we deal with, even if it is by email, you know, it gets sent to me. So yeah, I did fill it in, yeah.
Good. Okay, well, I think it's really good to hear that you make time to send feedback, because honestly, nowadays, it's actually quite a big struggle getting people to complete quality surveys and to actually score the service, let alone to provide their comments. A lot of them are quite used to just putting scores down for each part of the service, but then they don't leave any comments for the removal companies as well, you know, for further improvements, or even just to praise a part of their service which they felt went really well.
And I think that's very important, especially from the praise point of view. So, you know, the companies know what they're doing right. And then the companies also understand what is frustrating for the actual expats, what, you know, what they're not getting. So, yeah, I think it's very important.
I love what Gail said. Happy wife, happy life. How true. The reality is that in many circumstances, the wife really is the point person when it comes to managing the move. And it's so important that whoever the moving company is, make sure that they are attentive to their needs. Also, pay attention, moving companies. As Gail said, she recommends that all moving companies provide a survey. Providing a survey tells clients that as a company, you are concerned about their experience and you're always trying to improve on the services that you offer. In part 5 of our final interview with Gail, we're going to talk about her experience during COVID and her thoughts on technology to help improve the move process itself. And if you'd like, you can watch part 5 by clicking the link at the end. Take care, everyone.